No, we discussed about that SOCAS notice, and we are going to take a decision on that in the cabinet.
What about the legalities, sir?
Because there are no competent authorities approach this governor except for a private complaint. Can it be legally tenable, sir? Because no police has approached.
No, all that we are going to discuss in the cabinet. We can't. I cannot reveal the position of legal position of the SOCAS notice.
Sir, Minister Gawai in the Supreme Court says the state should evolve in a policy to identify the creamy layer among the SC/ST to gain the true equality. How do you read this, sir?
No, this has been going on for a long time. You know, constitution had to be amended, and so many procedures had to be followed. See, internal reservation, people have been talking right from Lok Sabha to all these assemblies. I think this will also probably help in resolving that.
So, final question, sir, do you think many of your MLAs also feel that Delhi is targeting the Congress government and the Congress party through Raj Bhavan? How do you see this?
No, politically, yes. We also, see that in the same line. We also see that, that they tried ED, they tried CBI, and now they are using the governor's office, which is not in accordance with the constitutional provisions.
Last question to you, sir. The BJP planned its Padayatra yesterday. Mr. H.C. Kumaraswamy himself has put out. There's a massive risk there, sir, between both the ally partners. Have you given
Let them resolve the infights first, and then take out the Padayatra.
See, Raj Bhavan has been misused by the BJP, that is very, very clear. In Tamil Nadu, in Jharkhand, in Maharashtra, in Delhi, in West Bengal, I can give you umpteen number of examples where opposition ruled states are there. So there is not a surprise. And we were thinking that our governor was, compared to other of the BJP governors, was a little bit better. But looks like he is also becoming a puppet in the hands of BJP. And the way he is approaching these things is definitely very, very, something which is very regrettable. And it is unconstitutional also, I think, sir, the way he is acting.
And the Padayatra is continuing what they say. After the rift, now they have convinced each other saying that let's go ahead because the
timing
is important.
That is for them to do. We will do what we have to do. But what is most important is that today a cabinet meeting is there. After that, our people will brief the media, and you will get all the details of what we are going to say after that.
Thank you.
Sir, have you also decided to go legally and take it legally the issue?
See, definitely it is a legal issue, and it is just it's very clear that this is an attempt to destabilize. When they could not do it through ED and IT and CBI, now they're using Raj Bhavan also for the same purpose. Same purpose.
So will you discuss this in the
Yes, of course. The cabinet meeting has been called primarily for this reason.
Is there a plan to pass a resolution?
That you will come to know once the meeting is done and we conclude the meeting. Our ministers will address the media.
Either Lokayukta, CBI or police, how can the governor give prosecution permission? Is there a question?
See, the question has not reached that level. Right now it is in the stage of SOCAS notice being given to Honorable Chief Minister, which is basically on a wrong premises. We are discussing that in the cabinet today. The Chief Minister has nominated Deputy Chief Minister to preside because since allegations are against him and the SOCAS notice has been given to him, he feels that I should not be part of the discussion. You all discuss and take decision. This is what he has taken on a high traditional, high tradition of not making any decision biased.
CM has authorized me. I don't know. I'm going to the cabinet.
MLAs are feeling that Delhi is targeting the Congress government and the party through Raj Bhavan after ED and CBI. How do you see this?
See, after the cabinet meeting, definitely I will come. I'll react to it. We'll explain. And there is a constitution. There is a democracy. There is a will of the people. We'll explain all of this.
How was your meeting with the Prime Minister?
Yes, I have apprised him because Bangalore is very important. Bangalore is a state a city which is giving them a lot of revenue. The world leaders and world investors are coming to Bangalore. We should, at the time of Manmohan Singh ji, there was a big infrastructure given to Bangalore. You see electronic city, you see a airport flyover, you see that Nelamangala flyover, including that on the way to Kolar, all these things was being given at the central government at that point of time. Now population has been increased a lot. Now I have requested the Honorable Prime Minister to help us, including giving us to go to this ring road. Not the ring road that where the IT areas are there.
Elevated road.
Not elevated, ring road connected to that Madhepura constituency, you know. There, that ring road. I think we have requested for a military land.
Okay.
17 kilometers. We want to make a bypass between that MG road and that road connectivity so that it will save 1 hour for the common man. So we have requested that. We met the defense minister also. We have requested the prime minister also. I have requested the UD minister also in connected to that. So, and the finance fund for all these things, including the tunnel and various development project and whatever they had committed in the budget, we have requested that. They have assured that they will look into it. And I hope some judgment will prevail upon
the fight between Kumar Swami and BJP. There's a fight between Kumar Swami and BJP.
Huge fight, sir.
Kumar Swami said
I don't know.
BJP is disrespecting him.
No. See, it is their political. They have to retain their base. No. How can BJP take over their base? It is quite natural. Yeah.